I wanted to create a completely free website. I mean, no credit card verification, no coupons, no trials, just an honest to God, $0 simple website in the easiest way possible. Is it even doable? Well, after a quick Google search, the number one recommendation that came up time and time again was Wix. But it's just a bad recommendation. I know, because I've dealt with Wix before. They kinda scam you into allowing you to spend hours designing the website for free, and only when you press the publish button, you have to deal with all of the aftermath. Your website design gets this huge ad on top of it that's always visible and impossible to hide, and you get a random website name that definitely can't go onto a business card and is pretty much impossible to remember. So, as a free website builder, Wix is complete trash. But at least now, I know what to look for. 1. It has to be free. 2. There must be no or minimal ads. And 3. The URL must be comprehensible. So I've done my research and tried out 8 more services, and all of these fail in at least one of my points. For example, WordPress.com. Nope, has a huge ad. YouCraft? That's an ad. GoDaddy? Whoa mama, that's a big ad if I've ever seen one. Oh, and this one even scrolls with the content. Very intrusive. Webnode, yep, that's an ad. Square, maybe? Ad right at the bottom. And for the builders that don't have a huge ad, well, the domain is all weird. Like, here is Jimdo, and the ad is manageable, but the name, come on. Or Canva, again, the ad is small, non-intrusive, but the website name, it has 3 dots. There should not be 3 dots in a website name, ever. And Site123 is, well, one of the worst offenders, offering a gibberish name paired together with a huge ad that scrolls with the content of your website. I have recreated my free website 9 times completely from scratch by this point. And I'm not going to lie, I thought this would be easier before getting into it, because I mostly create content around web hosting and server management. So from my experience, there are good free web hosting options on the market, like Google Sites, Cloudflare Sites, Oracle VPS, or Webhost Most free tier. But these are not website design tools. These are just server space where you can plop down your website files for free and then use WordPress. But it's not easy to use, and they do require you to have website files in the first place, either coding from scratch, buying a pre-made template, or designing and editing one via a third-party tool. But that requires like 5 different installations, cross-usage between several different tools, and in the end, you would still need to buy a website name separately or use something like this, which is just too damn long. I want something I can just pick up and get done in one evening. Is that delusional? Luckily, no, I actually found a good option. Card, completely free sign up, no credit card. The ad is at the very bottom of the page, plus it's completely minimal. Additionally, you can choose your website name before publishing. It will still be a .card.co, but card.co doesn't even sound that bad to me. You can almost pass it off like it's intentional, like here's my card. Their whole idea is a simple one-page website. It's fully drag and drop with no code required. I got to work trying to create this design I sketch up in Figma. I'm going for a freelancer slash personal small business type of site. So I want a nice hero section with a photo, then a button that would lead to my services, and some text to go along with it. Next, I need a link to some of my recent YouTube videos as a showcase of my editing slash writing style. And let's do a quick services section where I use icons and text to describe what I'm offering here. Finally, a contact section with my email and phone number to reach out if needed. Now all that's left to do is choose my website name. I'll go with something short, easy to remember and easy to pass on to people. And here we go. A completely free website I built with 0 tech skills. I think this does the job quite well, but of course, I am a technical person myself. I can do this via coding, and a good reason to do so, for me at least, is website speed. Website builders like Wix or Squarespace are notoriously slow, offering up to 10 or 15 times slower loading times for your users just because the platform is inefficient and bloated with features. And this is usually the case with most website builders. They make websites that look good, not work good. However, I was very pleasantly surprised by my free card website, because even when I ran a speed test from Amsterdam, my website responded in around 350 milliseconds and fully loaded in 2 seconds. When I tested from the United States, the site responded in around 250 milliseconds and loaded in around 2.5 seconds. And even when tested from Australia, it responded in around 800 milliseconds and loaded in 4 seconds. When compared to more technical solutions, yes, it is slower, don't get me wrong. You can get sub 1 second load times if you want to get your hands dirty and use a more complicated free solution. You can get even better loading times with custom built websites using paid web hosting. So developers are not out of a job just yet. But compared to other website builders, even paid ones like Wix, Squarespace, Site123, these speeds are really good for a free product and show worldwide accessibility without users having to wait 20 or 30 seconds for the website to load. In my opinion, Card achieves this by offering only single page websites. This means you can't create huge monstrosities full of content, it's not for blogging, and you can't host the next Facebook on it. It's for representing yourself online in a clean and easy to do so way. However, it's not all good. It doesn't matter which website builder you go for, even if you use paid website builders, your SEO or search engine optimization won't be good. It's like taking a go-kart to an F1 race. Your competitors that have custom-built sites just have so many tools at their disposal that they're much better at categorizing and informing Google on what their page is about. And all you can do is basically press stop or go, so they get ranked higher. By using a website builder that's free, your website has like a 1% chance to rank on Google for the keywords that you want. And maybe, just maybe 5 to 10% if you're using a paid version and you know what you're doing in terms of SEO. But even if I directly search for my free card site, Google doesn't even index it. It just completely ignores its existence. So keep this in mind and don't waste your time with SEO. Just promote your business directly via ads or cross-promote it between different platforms if you're going this route. SEO basically doesn't exist with a website builder and is a complete waste of time, in my opinion. I also know that I dismissed Wix very early on in this video, and I want to give more weight to that decision. The reason you see the same recommendations made absolutely everywhere, and why is it so hard to find a decent solution on Google these days, is that these content creators are mega corporations with hundreds of employees, and they're really good at SEO. They also get paid if you ever purchase a subscription to a service they recommend. So naturally, they just push what pays them the highest percentage commission to maximize profit, not look out for your best interests. Since Wix is the biggest player in the market, it pays the most money for signups. That's why Wix is ranked number one everywhere. They simply have the most money to pay creators to be on these lists. But since I'm a WordPress purist myself, I generally never recommend people use website builders. I personally hate website builders. I think they're a ripoff created to scam unsuspecting new webmasters, and I would never recommend you use one. I don't care about the commissions, I just want for you to find the best option, and in my research, that was Card. They thoroughly impressed me. I never recommend people use website builders, so Card is joining the list of the second only website builder I've ever recommended on this channel, followed by the Hostinger website builder, which is a paid option. I feel like these are the only two options that are good enough to compete with these highly technical solutions or content management systems like WordPress, or in Card's case, the free package is so good for people that are looking for something simple that I simply can't ignore the convenience of it. However, If you're not afraid to get your hands dirty and you want that sub 1 second speed and you want that SEO customizability, watch this video next, where I can showcase how to create a complicated multi-page website completely free of charge in the best and most efficient way possible using WordPress. Good luck creating your websites, and I hope you've learned something new.